ball at the line of scrimmage. You've got to make him go east and west. And if you don't do those things, it's going to be tough. If you do those things, you got a chance. But they are big, physical backs, no question.
You saw a couple weeks ago with Jeff Driscoll, the dual threat kind of guys.
Mm-hmm.
Murray doesn't get the credit maybe he deserves with his athletic ability. Guys that were in Athens last time, you know, saw him really burn Tennessee with his legs.
Right.
How different is that, from the safety's perspective? Do you backpedal and keep going deep with the receiver, or you see the guy roll out? How confusing can that be for a guy?
It doesn't change too much initially, but when he gets out on the perimeter and he starts to scramble, that's when it affects you a little bit more. He's got good legs. He can run. He can make plays when he's on the run. Obviously, you want to disrupt the timing early in the down, but when he has those loose plays and he's scrambling outside the pocket, that's when it becomes a little bit more evident that you have to get in coverage. You have to stay in coverage because he's making those plays on the perimeter.
Thanks, Coach.
Is
Byron, obviously, good game on Saturday. You see him get better each and every game.
Byron is getting better. You know, I think all those guys are getting better, but he's made a lot of improvements as he's gone through the season, and it's good to see. He's been a productive guy, and he's going to continue to be productive. He just keeps approaching it the right way. The thing that I like about Byron is when he goes about this day-to-day process, there's not a lot of flashiness to him. You know, he's not maybe what you would say a dynamic guy as far as personality. He doesn't draw a lot of attention to himself, but in my opinion, that's what the great ones do. He just goes about his job, does his job every single day, and at the end of the week, on Saturday, he's produced at a high level. And that's been the last 2 or 3 weeks, you know what I mean?
And now, he talked about, you know, when Brian went down, kind of stepping up, and I understand he kind of had more responsibility.
Yeah.
Did you see any change in him? I know you mentioned he's kind of has the same demeanor, same kind of work.
Oh, yeah, there's no doubt. He's stepped it up. He's gone to work every day. I don't think it's changed, you know, too much, but you've seen a little bit more maybe urgency, and he understands that, hey, I am kind of the leader back there. I've got to be the guy that's in charge, so I'm going to be the one that takes control of it and make sure everybody gets on the same page. And if a star needs to blitz, I'm going to tell the star he needs to blitz. And if he's in coverage, I'm going to tell him he's in coverage. And you can see him starting to take over that role that Brian was doing a little bit more, making sure everybody's on the same page out there. Now, is it going to be 100% perfect? No, but that's what we're shooting for, and he's taking that role on.
With Ladero, was it kind of disappointing not to get him some more looks on Saturday, and how close is he moving?
You know, I don't know if it was disappointing. The game just didn't lend itself to it, but we told him, you know, in the next 2 or 3 weeks he needs to be prepared to take some more reps. He's going to be a guy that's going to probably take some reps this week. He'll see more reps. He'll see more action. The more that he's taken on special teams, the more that he's gotten out there on the practice field, he's becoming more and more confident. And I'm confident, you know, with putting him out there. I think any time that you look at a player and the more that you become confident as a coach and understand, hey, he can get the job done, he starts to get confident, and we put him out there, I think he'll be just fine.
What do you need to see from Ladero to feel a little